3IAtlas has stunned astronomers with an extraordinary surge in brightness. In just 4 weeks, it grew 5 times brighter than predicted by standard cometary models. At its distance, over 6 astronomical units from the Sun, this kind of activity shouldn't even be possible. Normally, water, ice, and common volatiles remain frozen that far out, leaving comets faint and relatively inactive. But ʻOumuamua refused to play by the rules. Telescopes including TESS, ZTF, and ʻOumuamua itself consistently confirmed the light curve. Smooth, steady, and persistent. This wasn't a fluke of the instruments, a glitch in the data, or a passing background star. Every check lined up, proving the object's brightness was real. What makes this even stranger is the timing. ʻOumuamua began glowing strongly before it even entered the warmer inner regions of the solar system. Its coma and dust cross-section grew at rates far beyond natural expectations. To many scientists, this looks like a message written in light, a signature of something different, perhaps even intentional. If it's natural, we'll need a brand new explanation. If it isn't, this could be the first sign that ʻOumuamua is more than just another comet. When 3IAtlas first entered our view, it almost slipped completely under the radar. In May 2025, NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, better known as TESS, captured faint traces of the object moving against the dense star fields near the galactic center. But at the time, no alert was triggered. The signal was drowned in a sea of background stars, and its motion was too subtle for automated detection systems. For nearly a month, ʻOumuamua traveled across the sky unnoticed, leaving a hidden trail of clues buried deep inside survey archives. It wasn't until July that the ʻOumuamua project, observing from its Chilean station, flagged an anomaly. This faint object had suddenly brightened fivefold. Within 24 hours, observatories around the world pivoted to track it, and the race to piece together its history began. Amateur astronomers quickly joined the hunt. By combing through terabytes of publicly available data, they uncovered pre-discovery images from June that had been missed in real time. These contributions filled critical gaps, allowing researchers to reconstruct ʻOumuamua's early light curve. What emerged was a picture of an object already behaving strangely before it was officially recognized, brightening faster and earlier than any natural explanation could fully account for. In this way, ʻOumuamua wasn't discovered in one dramatic moment. It was slowly revealed, like a cosmic puzzle solved piece by piece. And without the teamwork of both professionals and citizen scientists, much of its bizarre early behavior would have remained hidden. One of the strangest things about 3IAtlas is the way it moves. Comets normally act like natural rockets. As the Sun warms their icy surfaces, jets of vapor shoot into space, pushing the nucleus slightly off course. Astronomers call this the non-gravitational acceleration, and it's measurable in every active comet we've ever tracked. But ʻOumuamua refuses to follow this rule. Even though it has a visible coma and a tail stretching hundreds of thousands of kilometers, its orbit hardly changes at all. Careful astrometric measurements show a drift of just about 1 kilometer per day. So small, it's almost gravitationally pure, as if the comet were nothing more than a heavy, inert rock. For comparison, the last interstellar comet, 2I Borisov, drifted nearly 100 kilometers per day under the same effect. Before we dive in, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. You don't want to miss any updates on the universe's deepest secrets. And if you love exploring hidden mysteries and unexplained discoveries, give this video a like so we know to keep uncovering them. This contradiction is striking. The coma is there, the jets are visible, but the expected rocket push is missing. If ʻOumuamua were truly just ice and rock, its outgassing should have nudged it far more than we observe. The numbers simply don't match up. So, what does this mean? Either ʻOumuamua is unusually massive and dense, far beyond what its brightness suggests, or something is actively stabilizing its path, keeping it locked in place against the forces that should move it. Natural explanations are struggling to keep up, and the mystery deepens with every new observation. If Atlas's motion wasn't strange enough, its chemistry has only deepened the mystery. Using some of the world's most powerful instruments, like the Very Large Telescope in Chile, astronomers turned spectrographs toward its coma, the glowing cloud of gas and dust that surrounds its core. What they found was baffling. Clear, well-resolved lines of nickel appeared in the spectrum, showing that nickel atoms were being released steadily into space. But iron, which should always accompany nickel, was virtually absent. In normal comets, iron and nickel exist in lockstep, forged together in ancient supernovae and planet-building processes. The Sun itself contains roughly 18 atoms of iron for every one atom of nickel. Even the dustiest, most metal-rich comets we've studied never show nickel outweighing iron by more than a factor of 2. Atlas, however, shattered this rule. Its nickel-to-iron ratio wasn't just unusual, it was extreme, with nickel outpacing iron by more than 15 times, perhaps even 50. Every attempt to tease out a hidden iron signal failed. The imbalance was real, so what could cause this? Natural theories struggle. Some suggest exotic chemical processes or fragile nickel compounds releasing gas more easily than iron. Others have gone further, raising the possibility of engineered residues. Nickel-rich alloys eroded from ancient technology. For now, no explanation fits neatly, leaving Atlas's spectral fingerprint one of the most puzzling clues yet in this interstellar mystery. When astronomers face something unusual, the first step is always to search for natural causes. Could Atlas's bizarre brightening, strange motion, and chemical imbalance all be explained without invoking anything extraordinary? At first, the answer seemed possible. But the deeper scientists dug, the more every familiar explanation began to fall apart. Take the nickel-iron puzzle. One idea was that fragile nickel compounds, like nickel carbonyl, might break down at low temperatures, releasing nickel gas earlier than iron. But iron doesn't behave the same way. Its compounds rarely form or survive under those conditions. Another suggestion was selective sputtering, where solar particles chip away at surface material in unusual proportions. Yet no known process produces the extreme ratios seen in Atlas's coma. And then, there's the motion problem. If Atlas were losing mass through jets of gas and dust, its orbit should be shifting dramatically. Instead, it stays locked in a nearly perfect gravitational path. The only natural way to explain this would be for Atlas to be so massive that outgassing barely moves it. But measurements of its brightness and coma size show that it isn't nearly large enough to account for that kind of stability. One by one, the natural options are being tested and discarded. Each observation tightens the margins, leaving fewer explanations on the table. The result is a growing sense of tension. Either Atlas is teaching us comet physics we've never imagined, or something entirely different is at play. With natural explanations failing, some astronomers, and many outside observers, have begun to wonder if 3IAtlas might not be entirely natural. The idea is controversial, but it keeps resurfacing because Atlas behaves in ways no comet should. One speculation is that Atlas is being actively controlled. Its resistance to the normal rocket push of outgassing could suggest deliberate braking maneuvers, as if something were stabilizing its orbit. A second possibility comes from the unusual nickel-rich spectrum. Instead of a natural imbalance, could this reflect engineered alloys, materials refined for strength, durability, or even spacecraft construction, slowly eroding into space? The hypothesis is not without precedent. When ʻOumuamua passed through in 2017, some researchers proposed it might be an artificial light sail, thin and controlled by sunlight. Atlas shares a similar interstellar origin, but presents new puzzles. Its brightening, its stability, its spectral fingerprint, that push some to revisit the question of intelligent design. Of course, evidence so far remains circumstantial. Every anomaly has natural possibilities, even if they stretch the limits of physics and chemistry. Most scientists are cautious, avoiding sensational claims until data forces their hand. Still, the artificial control idea hangs in the background, whispered not only in fringe communities but increasingly in professional discussions. ʻAtlas may be a comet, or it may be something much stranger, but the possibility of intelligence cannot yet be ruled out. To understand 3IAtlas, astronomers have looked back at the only two other known interstellar visitors, ʻOumuamua in 2017 and 2II Borisov in 2019. Together, they form a strange trilogy, and ʻAtlas seems to complete the set by doing the opposite of what came before. ʻOumuamua was the first shock. It looked like no comet we had ever seen, long, thin, and tumbling. But the real puzzle was its motion. It accelerated as if pushed, yet no outgassing was ever detected. No coma, no jets, nothing to explain the force nudging it away from a purely gravitational path. That anomaly still haunts planetary scientists today. 2 years later, 2I Borisov arrived, and it looked reassuringly familiar. A classic comet, bright coma, dusty tail, and strong outgassing that produced the expected non-gravitational acceleration. Borisov was chaotic, but comfortably natural. Now comes ʻAtlas, and it flips the script again. Unlike ʻOumuamua, ʻAtlas does have a coma and tail, but unlike Borisov, it doesn't show the acceleration those jets should cause. It's almost as if these three interstellar objects were deliberately contrasting one another. One without outgassing, but with acceleration. One with both, and one with neither. Whether coincidence or design, this odd sequence suggests that the population of interstellar visitors is more diverse and more mysterious than anyone imagined. ʻAtlas is not just another data point. It may be the strangest yet. One of the most important things to remember about 3IAtlas is just how rare it is. In the entire history of modern astronomy, only three confirmed interstellar objects have ever been observed: ʻOumuamua, Borisov, and now ʻAtlas. That's it. Out of billions of stars and trillions of comets in the galaxy, only these three have revealed themselves as visitors from beyond our solar system. This rarity means every anomaly carries enormous weight. If we had hundreds of examples, a single oddball wouldn't matter much. It could be chalked up as statistical noise. But with a sample size of just three, every detail becomes crucial. And so far, all three have been strange in their own ways. ʻOumuamua gave us unexplained acceleration without visible outgassing. Borisov looked like a normal comet, but was unusually volatile, shedding mass at extreme rates. And now ʻAtlas breaks the mold again, showing strong outgassing but almost no acceleration. With such a tiny set of interstellar visitors, it's hard to escape the feeling that something unusual links them. Statistically, the odds of three consecutive outliers appearing by pure chance are low. Either we've been extraordinarily lucky or extraordinarily unlucky, depending on your perspective. Or these anomalies point to a broader truth. Perhaps interstellar objects aren't rare oddities at all, but representatives of a population that defies everything we thought we knew. ʻAtlas, rare as it is, may be a messenger from that hidden population. Tracking 3IAtlas is not a job for a single observatory or a handful of astronomers. It's a global effort, from Chile to Hawaii, from South Africa to Australia. Professional telescopes are constantly sweeping the sky, recording every photon, every subtle change in brightness, every shift in spectrum. But even the most sophisticated instruments can't catch every twist in ʻAtlas's behavior. That's where amateur astronomers step in, forming an essential part of a worldwide network. Amateurs armed with backyard telescopes, CCD cameras, and open source software sift through vast amounts of archival data, filling in gaps between professional survey passes. They stitch together nightly exposures, build early light curves, and sometimes spot anomalies that automated systems miss. Their contributions have already proven crucial. Without them, the early five-fold brightening of ATLAS would have remained hidden for weeks. Communication is key. Discord channels, Telegram groups, and email lists allow observers to share alerts in real time. When a new outburst is detected in one part of the world, telescopes on the opposite side can immediately pivot, ensuring no event is missed. This coordinated effort doesn't just improve data quality, it also speeds discovery, turning scattered observations into a cohesive timeline of activity. Each additional observation sharpens the models. Astrometry, photometry, and spectroscopy from multiple sites allow researchers to calculate the orbit with unprecedented precision. Even subtle spectral features, like the unusual nickel-to-iron ratio, can be confirmed or refuted when multiple teams report consistent measurements. In effect, ATLAS has created a real-time scientific relay, where professionals and amateurs alike contribute to a living, breathing dataset that updates daily. The stakes are high. Every night counts as ATLAS rounds the sun. A sudden flare, a spectral anomaly, or an unexpected motion could provide critical clues to its origin and nature. By pooling resources globally, humanity maximizes the chances of catching these fleeting signals. The story of ATLAS is not just one of discovery. It's a demonstration of what coordinated, worldwide astronomy can achieve when the entire sky becomes a shared laboratory. When we step back and look at 3IAtlas as a whole, the picture becomes both fascinating and perplexing. On one hand, there is absolutely no proof that it is artificial or alien in origin. Nothing in the data definitively shows intelligent control, and scientists remain cautious, emphasizing natural explanations first. Yet the combination of ATLAS's behavior, its extreme brightening, its suppressed orbital drift despite a visible coma, and its unusual chemical fingerprint challenges everything we know about comets. Interstellar visitors like ATLAS force us to confront the limits of our understanding. ʻOumuamua, Borisov, and now ATLAS each display behaviors that don't fit neatly into existing models. In ATLAS's case, the very mechanisms that normally dictate comet motion seem to fail. Outgassing should push it off course, yet the object remains stubbornly on a near-perfect gravitational trajectory. Its spectrum defies expectations, with nickel outpacing iron in a way no known comet ever has. These contradictions suggest that interstellar objects might carry surprises we have yet to fully comprehend. This raises an exciting possibility. Perhaps the best clues about extraterrestrial technology or unknown astrophysical processes won't come from signals, radio waves, or lasers, but from observing the objects themselves. Their motion, their chemistry, and the light they reflect could be the first forms of evidence we ever detect. ATLAS reminds us that the universe still has secrets, and that interstellar visitors may not just be comets, they may be messengers, telling us something about the environments, processes, or even civilizations that exist beyond our solar system. Finally, ATLAS is a call to action for the scientific community and citizen scientists alike. By maintaining global networks, sharing data openly, and monitoring the sky relentlessly, we increase our chances of understanding these rare cosmic travelers. Each observation, each stack of images, and each measurement brings us closer to answering one of humanity's oldest questions. Are we alone? 3IAtlas may not give a direct answer, but it's challenging us to look closer, think bigger, and remain vigilant in the search for the unexpected.